Maine. I'm known from the Liffey down to Seguin, and I'm known by the name of Old Johnny Dew. Of all the trades a-going, now a-begging is the best, for when a beggar's tired, he can lay down to rest. He can beg for his meal, well, there's nothing else to do but to cart around the corner with his old rig-a-doo. I slept in the barn down at the Kirribon, awake for the morning. I slept till the dawn with the holes in the roof and the rain a-coming through. The cats and the rats, they were playing peek-a-boo. Who should awaken but the woman of the house, with her white spotted apron and her calico blouse. She began to frighten and I said, boo, don't be afraid, ma'am, it's old Johnny Dew. Fetch by and by, buy a pair of goggles and I'll color them blue, and an old-fashioned lady I will make her too. Over the hills with me pack on me back, over the hills with my great heavy sack, with the holes in the shoes and the toes peeking through. Skinnamarink-a-doodle, it's old Johnny Dew. Must be going to bed and now it's getting late at night. The fire's all lit and out goes the light, and now you've heard the story of my old rig-a-doo. Goodbye and God be with you, says old Johnny Dew. out one morning fair, all in the bloom of spring. I overheard a maid complain, most grievously did sing, saying cruel were my parents, they do me sore annoy, for they would not let me tarry with my bonny laboring boy. His cheeks are like the roses red, his eyes as black as sloes. He is meek in his behavior wherever that he goes. He is well sized, both neat and white, like a maiden's chastity. If I had my will, I would be still in my love's company. Says the mother to her daughter, why do you stoop so low? For to go and marry a laboring boy, around the world to go. Some noble lord might fancy you great riches to enjoy. So do not throw yourself away on a bonny laboring boy. Says the daughter to her mother, your talk is all in vain. For dukes and earls and lords and lairds, their efforts I would disdain. I'd rather live a humble life, where time I would enjoy, and loving him great respect, my bonny laboring boy. If I had all the riches now which great men have in store, 'tis freely I'd bestow them all on the lad that I adore. His beauty so entangled I'll ne'er deny, and in the arms of my laboring boy I mean to live and die. We'll fill our glasses to the brim and let the toast go round. Here's health to every sows the ground, who when his work is over, 'tis home he'll go with joy. And happy is the girl who wed my bonny laboring boy.
Thank you. song. And I bet several of you know more than one of these songs. So the first one is written by Fats Waller. I don't know who wrote the second one. Or the third one. And I don't know who wrote the song either.
Well, I only know that Debbie Reynolds sang it.
Debbie Reynolds, let's welcome into our space the spirits of Debbie Reynolds and Fats Waller. I call this the...
We've never done this before. We ate this thing.
I call this the Sin Suite. The Sin Swing Suite.
I love you.
more time to throw them all together in one big mess. I invite you to choose the one song that you'd like to sing. Don't be shy, help us. It's even weirder and better when you sing. So choose the one that you want. Come on, Ellen, I'm on that one. Here we go, ready? Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, here we go.
Just be sure that you say that I love you. It is a sin to tell a lie. Oh, those sweet magnolia blossoms, or the bunnies, or do those folks eat that possum? Will they can't eat no more? I'm gonna sit right down and write myself a letter, and then I'll close with you both twins.
Build it any way you wanted, and I was trying to get some free labor, and I did. These guys built the stage and started playing kind of, I think, the end of June of 1998. You were looking for a home because of the yes, and I was it. You were
stageless.
I have to tell you a funny thing that happened, though. The night before I opened the store, you know, You are so excited about your new store. You have a new sign out in front, and you've got your stuff laid out there. And I was here till 2 in the morning with a friend, running in and out the door, looking, seeing if the lighting was just right, and coming over and moving a book 3 inches this way or that way. And we have the mayor, by the way, Mayor Mike Paul is here tonight. And I want to pay attention to this, because this is a City of Baraboo story, if ever there was. The next morning, I come dragging in after being here till 2 o'clock tweaking the windows. And I come in and I hear, and I go, what the heck? And I run up here and my window is full of dust. The City of Baraboo has removed my sidewalk. Removed the curb.
Yes.
What's a girl to do? And I throw the newspaper can and said, we want to interview you, but what are you going to do? And I said, well, you know, if your business depends on what it's going to be the first week or so that you're open, you're in deep trouble, right? So we better have a longer range plan than that. He said, well, we'd like to take your picture. Where do you want to have that? He's looking at the books. And I said, right out there. So we went out there, and I climbed through the rubble. I was a lot more adept at climbing through rubble some years ago. Anyway, and I stood out there, and I was wearing this dress that I wore today, just to show that. Because it was the dress in the picture that was on the front page of the newspaper, and thus started my career of trying to eke out free publicity anywhere that I could. Want to say another thing as I see Homer back there. One of the things that happened here is I had fabulous landlords. The Fritches were just great, and Janet was just wonderful to this day as a landlady. I had the best neighbors, though, that you could possibly have, and that was Homer, who was upstairs with his studio up there. And next door, where Amber Moon now is, was the garden party. And Terry Leonard's, just those people couldn't have been more welcoming. I said to people, you know, I'm shocked. I've never depended or had neighbors like this that I thought I could turn to if I needed help. And I have turned to Homer. I have called Homer in the middle of the night to come and get tiger trainers out of my driveway when needed. So. But I want to thank everybody here. I've said this before to this group and I think it bears saying again. The city can do things, and the Downtown Baraboo organization can do things, and I can do things, and all the other businesses can do. Yeah, we can have wine walks, we can have all this stuff, but if the community doesn't get up off their butts and participate, nothing happens. And that's what you guys do. And you've been wonderful, and you've made this whole thing happen that's much bigger than a bookstore. The bookstore is the part I have to do. But you all being here, and you guys providing the music and the your talents for all these many 15 years. I just can't thank you all enough. So, without further ado...
What did you say?
Before you say anything, right? I'd like to offer a friendly amendment to your sorority, the opening of the bookstore.
Yep.
What you don't you didn't mention was that the bookstore for the first few days of its existence, weeks of its existence, was not what it is now. This wall is way up there. It's up by the first
where the burgundy carpet ends. That's where
the entire bookstore was about
100
square feet.
But I'm talking free labor. I'm talking free labor. Listen to this. Listen, go ahead. Tell
so we walk. You walk into this big long story, and you can't go back more than 6 feet. And there's Annie sitting behind you.
In the window.
It was like a little quaint English bookstore, right?
Exactly.
I thought I could pass this off.
And so we said, well, this is kind of interesting, but you're going to have to expand. So we had to move this wall all the way back before we could build the stage.
But first they had to clean up this thing and put the carpet down. And then you moved the wall back.
And we didn't like lay the wall down or take it apart. We moved the wall.
We moved the wall. And I said, I'm going to go away now. And I left. But about an hour and 45 minutes later, I came creeping around the square, and I didn't see emergency vehicles, and I came by, and I see guys sitting around with big smiles talking, and I see this big open space, so I knew I could come in. No one had died in the process.
So it was a team effort, but Annie was the leader of the team. And
well, it takes a village.
Many years, Annie has... let the most outrageous things happen under her roof.
There is a memoir.
So far, no one's been arrested. That may change tonight. I don't know. But Annie has played host and godmother and cook and babysitter and dog sitter and book advisor to so many, 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 many people. And almost every week, Friday, you can walk in here and something good is going on. And I know Annie works very hard to do that. So.
And I was on the shady side of 50 when I started. it's not pretty.
Where she remains.
Yes.
Kurt, have you just said it takes a village bookstore to raise a community?
Oh. That's right. Speaking of cooking and food, there are treats. We'll have cake in a little while. I also wanted to mention, I don't want to bring up the sales of books or anything like that. But if you bought a book, it's 15% off, of course, right? Yeah. Won't be right, but it seemed like a good number.
Will you autograph it with 15th
anniversary? Oh, yes. We have Kurt's new book here, too. We can autograph that.
Oh, my gosh.
Right? Kurt's outside his name.
Kurt's in himself.
Outside his name, they get 15% off.
You should have brought it with.
And now I would get off the stage if I only knew how.
Oh, Annie Randall, yay!